Hello Suzanne, welcome back to my channel. I hope that you guys are all having an awesome day so far. Happy New Year to everyone. I am sending you all the positive vibes, all of the abundance, and I hope that you are excited for a newer start this year and go into it with a positive mindset. So yeah, just all the good wishes to all of you. And for those of you who are new to my channel, maybe it's your first time clicking on one of my videos, welcome. Happy New Year's to you guys as well. My name is Diana and I am a Canadian expat that's been living and working in Berlin, Germany for the last 4 years. And today we're specifically going to be talking about moving to Germany in 2021. I can't believe I'm saying 2021, but here we are. And I've been talking to a lot of you over on Instagram, in the comments. I love connecting with all of you guys and talking to you, hearing your stories, hearing about your plans. And I know that a lot of you are wanting to move to Germany and start that process this year. So we're gonna be talking about what that's looking like and, you know, any doubts that you may have given the current situation that we're in. So a very common question that I get from a lot of you in the comments, on Instagram, even through our one-on-one coaching calls, is you're wondering if it's even possible to still move here to study and to work given the current situation that is happening. And I want to remove any stress and any limitations that you may be placing on yourself because of things that are happening. And I want to let you know that yes, it is definitely still possible for you to move here to work and to study. If you have a letter of acceptance from a German university, if you have a job offer, a job contract from a German company, then it is still possible for you to move here and for you to keep going on with that goal that you have. So that is amazing news because you don't have to put your goals on pause towards moving here. You don't have to wait for everything to go away and things to return back to normal. You still have the ability to move here. And through many of the coaching calls that I've done, I have seen that a lot of you have gotten letters of acceptance, have gotten job offers, and you've either already moved here, which is super cool, or you are in the process of moving here earlier on this year. So I love hearing these success stories, so it's really, really cool for me to be able to share it with all of you now. Now, something that I do want to mention is that because of a lot of German embassies around the world have been really backed up with, you know, a ton of paperwork, they were closed during the early part of last year, there's still quite a backlog. So if a typical visa time would take, you know, 1 month to process, we are seeing now double that time. So that is something to keep in mind, that it may take a bit longer to process your visa, whether it's a student visa, a job seeker visa, or a working holiday visa. There are delays in certain countries just depending on what the situation is like and whether or not there were full lockdowns. So that's just something that I do want to warn you of. But again, they are still processing visas and you can still move here. Now, the next thing I want to talk about is the Skilled Workers Immigration Act, which came into effect in March of last year. And this is so that people who are highly skilled workers or have vocational training are able to move to Germany to work, and it makes it a lot easier for employers to hire foreigners to fulfill those positions. I have a full video dedicated to the Skilled Workers Immigration Act and you know what the process is like, so I will leave it linked down below, and I'm also gonna leave a playlist right over here of videos that I've done on working in Germany and talking more about visas and CVs and all of that so that you can get started with that process yourself. So if you're someone who qualifies as a highly skilled worker, whether that be that you're an engineer, a data scientist, a registered nurse, a doctor, someone with vocational training, then your chances of being able to move to Germany are very, very high, and the chances of you being able to process your visa in a much quicker time and even obtain a blue card once you do move to Germany is increased quite a lot. So if you do qualify for that, I highly recommend still, of course, moving forward with your application, and hopefully that will give you an extra boost of encouragement, because there is still a lack of the skilled workers in Germany. And I've mentioned this throughout last year, but during, you know, the situation and the climate that we're in right now, I know that a lot of companies and a lot of countries have gone into deep recessions. Germany obviously was still impacted financially. Businesses have had to close, but there is still always going to be winners in situations like this. There are still a ton of companies in Germany that are thriving, companies that were able to get through the last year and are starting to gain momentum again and starting to, you know, become more financially stable. So this just means that companies are going to start to hire more. They're going to have to fill these positions. So I highly recommend, again, moving forward with your applications and moving forward with your goals of moving here. Another common question that I do get during the one-on-one calls that I do is whether or not, you know, companies are still going to have you move here, even though a lot of people are doing remote work. Are they still going to process the visa? Are you still going to be able to ultimately live here? And my answer to this is it depends, of course, on the company. But I have seen from, you know, personal experience of speaking to many of you, that companies in Germany are still processing visa applications for people abroad who need to move here and fill that position. So even though, you know, things are a little bit shaky right now, even though people are still doing remote work, I still find that for German companies, it is important for them to have their employers within the same country. A lot of German companies are very hopeful that things are going to return back to normal. And a lot of companies are now saying that maybe in the long term, yes, people will be able to do remote work, maybe 1 or 2 days out of the week, but for the rest of the week, people will have to be in the office. So of course, they are going to want their whole team to be there. So I always think that it's very good for you to pursue applying for jobs here, even if, you know, things are remote at the moment, because let's say you start working for a German company right now and you're not able to move for 2 more months. At least during that time, you would have got to work with a German company remotely. You would have been able to build more rapport with your team. And let's say when you actually move here 2 or 3 months down the line, once your visa is processed and things, let's say, have gone back to normal by then you would have built a stronger relationship with your team, and your transition of moving and working to Germany will be a lot easier. So I have seen a lot of success with remote work, and I think it looks really nice on your CV to have, you know, a German company on it, even if you have been doing work remotely, because let's say later on you want to transition to another company, at least you will have that experience of working for a German company, working with a German team, and it can show that you can work with the German culture and you have a good understanding of it as well. So do not disregard remote work. Even if you see a company that's just hiring remotely right now, it does not mean that you can't move over here. Again, I think it's just going to facilitate the whole process for you and just make it a lot easier for you to actually transition here and get that visa sorted out once things do settle down, and, you know, once people start going back into the office more regularly. And for those of you who are interested in studying here, the situation is pretty much not changed, you know, a lot in the last few months. You're still able to apply for studying here. Universities are still accepting students from abroad, and students here are pretty much just studying online, studying remotely. So it's quite similar right now to working right now. Everyone's just doing things remotely. But again, you are still able to move here and get your student visa sorted, and there's no issues despite everything that is going on. But that is gonna be today's video, just a quick little update on what it's like to move here in 2021. Again, please stay posted. Make sure to hit subscribe down below. You can follow me on Instagram as well, because because I will keep you guys updated as the situation progresses here and as things start to develop as well. If you are truly ready to get started with the process of moving here, I do offer the one-on-one coaching call. So if you want to go through your specific questions, get specific advice, I will go ahead and leave a link down below so that you can schedule it. And I also have an ebook that you can check out, which of course will be linked down below with everything else. But that's going to be pretty much all for today's video. I hope that you guys have an awesome one, and I will talk to you all in my next one. Tschüss!